Incredible! How China built university campus on Waterway in 1 year. How China used tech in classrooms. South China Normal University, SCNU, the Department of Education of Guangdong Province, and the People's Government of Shan Wei completed an agreement on establishing a new campus of SCNU in the city of Shan Wei on May 6, 2021. With that, enrollment of its first batch of students will start on the following September 2021. SCNU Shan Wei Campus. Shan Wei is in the coastal area of southeastern Guangdong Province, in southern China, while the Shan Wei Campus of SCNU is located in the city's downtown area, near the exit of Main Highway. It enjoys convenient transportation with the two high-speed rail stations in close proximity, as well as the pleasing scenery by the sea. The construction of the campus started on September 2020, is divided into three phases, of which the first stage is to build 948 acres and to be fully completed on August 2021 available for student enrollment. The next completion of the next two stages of 1,000 acres will follow respectively. Going forward, it plans to build 6 to 8 colleges and relevant teaching and research institutes, including about 20 undergraduate majors, with enrollments of other majors of around 5,000 students in 2025 and 10,000 by 2030. In addition, the campus is mapping out the graduate education of majors, including pedagogy, engineering, and science. 6 majors offering master and PhD programs will be available by 2025. Technologies in the Chinese classroom. Technology is making teaching easier than ever. It has helped make Chinese lessons more interactive and engaging, encouraging students to become more involved in the learning process. Number 1. The interactive board. They work just like traditional whiteboards, but instead of markers and erasers, you use a board connected directly to your computer and write questions and answers using a stylus pen, which doubles as a marker and mouse. With the help of interactive boards, you can turn any topic into an engaging lesson. Number 2. The Chairman's Bow. It helps teach classes by using Chinese news as the main source of curriculum and utilizing the tool for teaching reading and listening to students of all levels. Every article has an audio recording of the script read by a native speaker, and the news are divided into 6 different HSK levels, making it easy to find the appropriate skill level for the class. Number 3. Scritter. It is an app designed to help students improve their Chinese writing abilities. Through tablet or interactive board, students can learn characters by writing them with hands. And as they practice writing out different characters, the app shows them the correct stroke order while giving tips on how to write legibly. Artificial intelligence in China classrooms. Chinese schools have been experimenting with the use of artificial intelligence in the classroom. Jindawei Xiaoshan Primary School in eastern China recently used special headbands developed by US-based BrainCo to measure students' level of concentration. The headband would relay real-time data on how engaged the students were. The goal of the headbands was to help teachers quantify engagement from students so they could better individualize instruction to cater to the needs of each student. These headbands have caused a backlash, and some schools have pulled them from their classrooms. In other classrooms, students were found to be monitored using cameras. Using facial recognition software, AI technologies can analyze the behavior of students. Certain programs assign a score to each student based on levels of concentration displayed in the classroom. The Chinese government continues to encourage the adoption of smart classrooms as they continue to push the limits of Chinese education. High competition in China. The willingness to explore AI technologies in classrooms stems from the high level of competition in China. Prior to college, Chinese students must take a college placement test called the GOKO. The GOKO is viewed as a major determinant of success because a top score is the only way to get into the country's top universities. Success in China is directly tied to education, so parents are constantly looking for ways to get ahead. There is a greater willingness to adopt more of these new technologies because they're seen as a way to gain a competitive advantage.